SpaceX founder Elon Musk is hell-bent on building a second home for humanity on Mars. His aerospace company runs around-the-clock operations to develop the Starship and Super Heavy launch vehicle that will enable humanity to build a permanent base on the Moon and the first colony on Mars. With this bold ambitions, there is no time to waste. Time is crucial to achieve the spacecraft's development in our lifetime. Everything about the stainless steel Starship vehicle is new, designed and manufactured by SpaceX engineers. Perhaps the most complex is Starship's methane-fueled Raptor engines. Musk aims to increase the engine's thrust and efficiency, to be capable of lifting up to low Earth orbit, the stainless steel vehicle's own weight, plus 100 tons of cargo. It would become the most powerful and largest rocket in the world. The magnitude of the Starship program is not widely appreciated. It is designed to extend life to Mars and the Moon, which requires 1,000 times more payload to orbit than all current Earth rockets combined. Starship is under development at the Starbase facility situated in Boca Chica Beach, Texas, and Raptor engines are developed at its engine testing facility in McGregor, Texas. Musk's plan is to increase Raptor production rate enough to conduct a Starship flight, at least once every 2 weeks, in 2022. In a new leaked email, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk says that the company could go bankrupt if, by the end of 2022, it can't achieve Starship and Starlink milestones that are by all practical appearances out of reach. The news, first broken by Space Explored, comes about a week after CNBC reported that Musk was shaking up SpaceX's leadership by effectively firing its vice president of propulsion due to a lack of progress in the development of Starship's Raptor engine. Now, apparently after taking his first good look under the hood in a while, Musk says that the Raptor production crisis is much worse than it seemed a few weeks ago. Worse, the CEO has implied that if it can't get enough reliable Raptors made by the end of 2022, SpaceX will face a genuine risk of bankruptcy. The email raises both skepticism and several major questions. First and foremost, can there be any truth to Musk's claim that SpaceX could go bankrupt because of an unspecified Raptor production crisis and disaster? Musk's argument is simple enough. According to his estimations, the first generation V1 Starlink satellite internet constellation is financially weak by itself, which has led SpaceX to develop a much larger, more advanced second generation V2 Starlink satellite and constellation. That the company's existing Falcon rockets have neither the payload volume nor mass to orbit to launch. To efficiently launch the Starlink V2 constellation, then, Musk says SpaceX needs Starship to be operational. Up to that point, nothing in Musk's email implies that a Raptor production crisis could pose any serious harm to SpaceX beyond annoying delays. More than 2 years ago, Musk believed that Raptor V1.0 already cost less than $1 million to produce. As of 2021, SpaceX, again per Musk, is completing an average of one Raptor engine every 2 days, and currently has 35 functional engines installed on Starship and Super Heavy booster prototypes, in Boca Chica, Texas. Already, at a rate of one engine every 48 hours, SpaceX's Raptor production capabilities are theoretically strong enough to fully outfit a significant Starship fleet. Both stages of Starship are designed to be rapidly and fully reusable, and absolutely need to be to efficiently and rapidly launch SpaceX's Starlink V2 constellation. In theory, a production capacity of approximately 180 Raptors per year should allow SpaceX to outfit a fleet of 3 Super Heavies 99 engines, and 13 Starships 72 engines. Even if Super Heavy booster reuses initially no faster than Falcon, approximately 1 launch per month, and Starship reuses no faster than Dragon, approximately 3 launches per year, that fleet would be able to launch at least 36 times per year. Even if SpaceX's former propulsion executive somehow pulled the wool over Musk's eyes, tricking him into seeing engines that just weren't there and hiding hundreds of millions of dollars in secret cost overruns from the company's own accountants. An annual run rate of 100 Raptor engines at a cost of $5 million each would still be able to power a fleet of 6 reusable ships and 2 boosters capable of approximately 20 launches per year. Musk says that SpaceX will only face the risk of bankruptcy if it cannot achieve a Starship flight rate of at least once every 2 weeks next year, equivalent to 26 launches annually. Again, being deceived for years would be a terrible look, but nothing described above appears to have any chance of bankrupting SpaceX. However, the CEO also says that SpaceX is spooling up one or several factories to produce several million Starlink user terminals dishes per year in a process that will consume massive capital, and assumes that Starlink V2 satellites will be on orbit to handle the bandwidth demand. He even goes as far as to say that those millions of terminals will be useless otherwise. Once again, while what he describes is an undeniable hurdle for SpaceX, the company is making a choice to consume massive capital to spool up Starlink dish factories before the constellation capacity needed to take advantage of those dishes has been secured. SpaceX doesn't need to make such a massive investment so quickly, when it could instead split that money with Starship, ensure that Starship and Raptor and Starlink V2.0 satellites are ready or close to ready for routine launches, and then invest heavily in dish production. For example, just this month, SpaceX raised almost $350 million from investors that have a practically bottomless appetite for SpaceX investments. Combined, by the end of the year, SpaceX will have likely raised more than $2.3 billion in 2021 alone. Valued at more than $100 billion, the company could, as a last resort, feasibly raise double-digit billions in one fell swoop with an IPO. Put simply, the only way SpaceX could ever go bankrupt in the near term would be by consciously letting itself drown in a sea of life preservers. This is not to say that SpaceX doesn't have numerous massive challenges ahead of it, nor is it to say that its fundraising potential is truly limitless. Investors could eventually become disillusioned. It's entirely possible that it will take SpaceX years longer than Musk expects to begin routine Starlink V2.0 launches with Starship. Environmental approvals alone could easily preclude more than 5 orbital Starship launches in 2022, and potentially prevent regular launches well into 2023. But the fact of the matter is that, unless Elon Musk is telegraphing signs that the rest of the company's finances are a house of cards, the odds of SpaceX actually going bankrupt anytime soon are vanishingly small. In reality, he's likely just attempting to, for better or worse, instill some amount of fear and panic in SpaceX employees to encourage them to work more hours and take fewer days off. Starship's development also affects NASA's timeline to land astronauts on the moon by 2025, and the ability to colonize Mars in our lifetime. The spacecraft's success would enable the company to complete the deployment of the Starlink broadband satellite constellation comprised of 20,000 satellites, designed to connect rural and remote communities around the world to reliable internet. To date, Falcon 9 has launched a bit over 1,800 satellites. Starship will be capable of launching 400 internet-beaming satellites to orbit in a single mission, unlike Falcon 9, which can only launch 60 in its payload fairing. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.